Hello guys, how are you today? I hope you're fine. Today we're going to talk about the characteristics of living things. All living organisms, whether they are single-celled or multicellular, plants or animals, show the characteristics, these seven characteristics. These are movement, respiration, sensitivity, growth, reproduction, excretion, and nutrition. And there is one way of remembering this list of characteristics of living things is by using the mnemonic Mrs. Gren, which represents M represents the movement, R represents the respiration, S is for sensitivity, G for growth, R for reproduction, E for excretion, N for nutrition. Let's start now to know each characteristic in details. So this is Mrs. Gren, okay, and these are the seven characteristics of living organisms: movement, respiration, sensitivity, growth, reproduction, excretion, nutrition. So let's start first by movement. Movement is an action by an organism or part of an organism causing a change of position or place. Most single-celled creatures and animals move about as a whole. Fungi and plants can make movements with parts of their body. Okay, so I'm going to give you examples for movement. So plants, they can move towards light. They can move towards light. This is the movement of plants. Animals move with their whole body by using their four limbs. Okay, and so on. The second characteristic is the respiration. All living things, they respire. Respiration describes the chemical reactions in the cell that break down nutrient molecules and release energy for metabolism. Most living things, they need oxygen for respiration, so they take in oxygen and give out carbon dioxide. So this is respiration. This is the second characteristic. The third characteristic is the sensitivity. It's the ability to detect or sense stimuli in the external or internal environment and to make appropriate responses. For example, plants are sensitive to light, so this means that the movement of the plant moves towards light, so they are sensitive to light. Man can respond to an external stimuli by touching any inappropriate surface or pin or such, which may lead to a reflex action. This is called sensitivity. They are sensitive, okay. And the fourth characteristic is the growth. Is a permanent increase in size and dry mass by an increase in the cell number or size or both. Even bacteria and single-celled creatures show an increase in size. Multicellular organisms increase the number of cells in their body, become more complicated and change their shape as well as increasing in size. So this is called growth. So number four, excretion, is the removal from the organisms of waste products of metabolism. Chemical reactions in the cells, including respiration, toxic materials and substances in excess of requirements. Respiration and other chemical changes in the cells produce waste products, such as carbon dioxide. So our body excretes carbon dioxide. Living organisms expel these substances from their bodies in various ways. Yes. This is called excretion. We can excrete through kidney, lungs, skin. These are the organs that are responsible for excretion in humans. So excretion is getting rid of the waste products, which mainly if they are kept in our body, they may lead to toxic problems in our body. Okay. Nutrition. is the taking in of materials for energy, growth and development. Plants require light, carbon dioxide and water and ions. Animals need organic compounds and ions and usually need water. Organisms can take in the materials they need as a solid food, as animals do, or they can digest them first and then absorb them, like fungi do, or they can build them up for themselves, like plants. Animals use ready-made organic molecules as food source, are called heterotrophs, and form the consumer levels of food chain. Photosynthetic plants are called autotrophs and are usually the first organisms in the food chains, which we call them producers. So here for nutrition, the plants, they are, we know that plants make their own food by themselves by a process called photosynthesis, and while living animals they feed on other animals or plants. Okay, so there are different types of ways that living things feed or they get their nutrition. Okay, I hope that today's lesson was beneficial, and I want you to let's revise quickly what are the characteristics of living things. So we said that there are 7 characteristics for all living things. For a living thing, so a living thing must have these 7 characteristics. If there is one missing, so it's, we don't consider it as a living thing. Okay, movement is the change in position by the action of muscles in animals, and slow growth movement in plants. Respiration is the release of energy from organic molecules. Sensitivity is the ability to detect and respond to changes in the environment. Growth is increase in size and mass. Reproduction, the creation of new organisms that are the same species as parents. Excretion is the removal of wastes from organisms' body, and we said the types, the different organs that are responsible for excretion. We said that kidney, lungs, skin. Nutrition, supplies an organism with food it needs to respire, grow, and repair and reproduce. So these are the 7 characteristics of living things. It's very important to know these characteristics very well. Okay, and I hope that you enjoyed today's lesson. It was beneficial to you. And if you like the video, please subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell for more videos. Thank you for listening, and bye for now.